Greetings and welcome to the Mount Pisgah AME Church's Youth and Young Adult Service. I am Reverend Brian, and on behalf of our pastor, the Reverend C. Michelle Langston, all of our youth leadership, and our Mount Pisgah AME Church family, I greet you and invite you to worship with us today. Today is Palm Sunday. This historic day marks the beginning of Holy Week, one of the cornerstones of our faith and what we believe. This is a time where Jesus, through his triumphal entry, declares himself as the Messiah to the world, marking the beginning of the end of his human earthly ministry. With the Lenten season ending soon, this is our time to truly reflect on what Jesus is about to experience, where we will see revealed the true passion of Christ, all for the love that God has for us. As always, may something that is said or done encourage you in your walk with God and help strengthen your relationship with our Messiah and Savior. And now, let's get ready to open our hearts, count our blessings, and give God some praise. Amen. It says in Romans chapter 6, verse 23, "For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord." I'm so glad that God had a plan to pay the price for my sins, because I know that I alone could not pay that insurmountable debt. But our God is gracious and merciful, and it is through the actions of Jesus that we can really see the love that he has for us. Whew. Man, if it was up to me, I would be the one crucified on the tree. Why? Because I can barely see through the sinful nature that I have right now. But thanks be to God that through Jesus, I can see clearly now. The rain is gone. It's going to be a bright, bright, sunshiny day. Ooh, let's pray. It's going to be a bright, 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 sunshiny day. Let's pray.
Let us now have a word of prayer. Dear Lord, thank you for this day. Thank you for life, health, and strength. Thank you for letting all of us come here virtually to learn more about you. I pray that we all take something from today's sermon and apply it to our lives. I pray that we do what we need to do to please you, and that you help us with our walk with you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Hello, this is Brandon.
And this is Bria.
We're going to sing the Lord's Prayer together.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever. Amen.
Hi, my name is Tiki Jr., and my favorite scripture is Matthew chapter 7, verses 1 through 3. Judge not that ye be not judged, for with what judgment ye judge, ye shall be judged, and with what measure ye met, it shall be measured to you again. And why beholdest thou the mote that is in thy brother's eye, but consider not the beam that is in thine own eye? Amen.
All my youth and my young adults, I just want to thank God for you. I thank God for you having the desire to want to seek God and have a closer walk with Him. And so as we continue to enter into God's presence, I pray God's blessings upon you, that God does a miraculous thing in your life, and He does exceedingly and abundantly, more than you can imagine or even think of, according to the power that's in you, and you have great power in you.
Kids, Dr. O here live in my learning lab, inviting you to join me next week, Holy Week, for some fun STEM classes where we're going to teach you all about Holy Week and why Jesus had to die and why it's so important for us. Now, I know it's Palm Sunday, and so I brought my Palm Sunday bag. And in this bag, we're going to give you a little sneak peek about what we're going to be learning during Holy Week. Let's see what's in the bag. We have muddy shoes on Maundy Thursday. Our lesson is called Muddy Feet, a Maundy Treat. Muddy Feet, a Maundy Treat. What does muddy feet have to do with Maundy treats? And what's Maundy anyway? You'll have to join us. What else is in my bag? The cross, the emblem of our faith. What's so good about Friday? Good Friday is the day that Jesus was crucified, and we know crucifixion was horrible, but it was horrible, but it was good. How can something that's so horrible be good? Guess you'll have to join us. What else is in my bag? Easter eggs. I love Easter eggs. You know why? Because they're always filled with candy. He is not here. He is risen. Okay. Maybe the next one I'll have candy. Wait, maybe the next one I'll have candy. They're all empty. Easter eggs in empty tombs. What does Easter eggs have to do with empty tombs? I guess you're gonna have to join us. Listen, get your parents to go to bit.ly/STEM Early Holy Week, where we're gonna do 3 live, really fun STEM classes. And get this, we're gonna do an Easter egg hunt at the church on Saturday. So make sure you sign up, Holy Week according to STEM. Join me right here in the Learning Lab where we learn all about Holy Week according to STEM. We'll see you there. And remember, STEM early, STEM often. Bye.
I've been crucified with Christ. Now he lives inside of me. I am now a son of God. I'm supernatural.
Okay, ladies, now it's your turn. All together now, let's sing. Okay, boys, it's your turn. All together now, let's sing.
I've been crucified with Christ. Now he lives inside of me. I am now a son of God. I'm supernatural.
One last time, we're gonna sing it all together. Everybody, let's go.
I've been crucified with Christ. Now he lives inside of me. I am now a son of God. I'm supernatural. I'm supernatural.
God's Story, Palm Sunday. So part of God's story happened on a day we call Palm Sunday, and it begins like this. Remember how God sent his son Jesus to rescue us? Well, not everybody believed that Jesus was really God's son and the rescuer. But the ones who did believe in him did something pretty cool on Palm Sunday. It started just like any other day for Jesus. He was heading into Jerusalem with his disciples. But before they got there, Jesus did something surprising. He stopped and sent two of his disciples to go get a young donkey from a nearby village. He even told them exactly where the owner had last tied it up. They weren't sure why he needed the donkey, but they obeyed him. Kids, would you be willing to obey Jesus, even if he asked you to do something you didn't understand? Anyway, when the disciples got back with the donkey, they threw their coats on its back like a saddle, and Jesus climbed up. Pretty soon, the disciples saw why Jesus needed it. See, crowds of people came to the road and started laying coats and tree branches to make a path for Jesus. When this happened, many people recognized that Jesus was a king. Only kings came into a city like this. So Jesus rode the donkey, like he was a one-man parade. And the crowds praised Jesus by yelling things like, "Blessed is the King who comes in the name of the Lord," and "Peace in heaven and glory in the highest," because they believed Jesus was the rescuer. But remember how some people didn't believe Jesus was God's son? Well, they told Jesus to make everybody stop yelling. They didn't think Jesus deserved to be treated like a king. You know what Jesus said? He told them, if they keep quiet, the rocks will cry out. Well, the people who didn't believe in Jesus didn't like thinking about people or rocks praising him. And that made Jesus sad. He actually started crying. And not just crying, weeping. Here, the people were standing next to the rescuer they'd been wanting and waiting for their whole lives, and they were missing it. But even though Jesus cried, Palm Sunday isn't a sad story. Easter is all about Jesus' amazing rescue, and Palm Sunday is a reminder of just how special that rescue is, and how much Jesus loves everyone. And that's the story of Palm Sunday. So in case you missed it, here's the quick version. Jesus was traveling. He sent his disciples to get a donkey. People spread coats and branches on the road. They praised Jesus. Some people didn't recognize that he was the king. That made Jesus sad. He had come to rescue them. A few days later, he would show just how much he loves us. And that's a part of God's story.
Slowly, slowly, Jesus, yeah, he came. Riding on a donkey, they would shout his name. Infatuated with a dream, they prepared his path. But nothing's as it seems, shouted praises wouldn't last. They waved palm branches so he could pass through. Echoing the words of the prophet, Zion's king has come to you. Yet Jesus wept, he shed those tears. Father, they don't know what is happening here. What do they expect? A sword from me? I'm armed with a piece, but they still couldn't see that I am you and you are me. Their king had come, come, come. And this is the plan, I'm no ordinary man. There's still work to be done, done. They wanted to be saved, but they couldn't see. I'm headed to the grave, they just want to use me to take over Rome so they can go home. The Savior before them, listen, I can ignore them, but I can restore them. Let's open our eyes, let go of the lies that hold us back over time. Our King has come to die for you and me. He did it on a tree so that we could be free. Raise your hands in the air and put them up high and give them all praise till our fingers touch the sky. And raise up your voice so that he can hear the sound. May it lift us off the ground while we're dancing in the clouds. Cause blessed is he who came in the name of the Lord. And he protects me, he's my shield and my sword. Narrow is the gate, so let's see that. The journey's just begun and I can't go back. Jesus is the way, the truth and the life. Come into my heart, turn the dark into light. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna. In the highest, you're the King of Kings, I can't deny it.
Read your Bible, forget to pray. you'll shrink, shrink, shrink. And you'll shrink, shrink, shrink. Don't read your Bible, forget to pray. And you'll shrink, shrink, shrink.
Sanctification is God's plan, growing me into a godly man. Read my Bible, pray every day. Got me living in God's way. I do my part, God does his. Sanctification, that's his biz. Growing up as a child of God. Kingdom kids, we God squad.
Read your Bible, pray every day. Pray every day, pray every day. Read your Bible, pray every day. And you'll grow, grow, grow. And you'll grow, grow, grow. And you'll grow, grow, grow. Read your Bible for every day. And you'll grow, grow, grow. And you'll grow, grow, grow.
It's time for the Word!
Today's scripture comes from the Gospel of John, chapter 12, verses 12 through 19, and it reads, "On the next day, much people that were come to the feast, when they heard that Jesus was coming to Jerusalem, took branches of palm trees and went forth to meet him, and cried, Hosanna! Blessed is the King of Israel that cometh in the name of the Lord. And Jesus, when he had found a young donkey, sat thereon, as it is written, Fear not, daughter of Zion, behold, thy king cometh, sitting on a donkey's colt. These things understood not his disciples at the first, but when Jesus was glorified, then remembered they that these things were written of him, and that they had done these things unto him. The people therefore that was with him, when he called Lazarus out of the grave, and raised him from the dead, bear record. For this cause the people also met him, for that they heard that he had done this miracle. The Pharisees therefore said amongst themselves, Perceive ye how ye prevail nothing? Behold, the world has gone after him. God's word for God's people. Amen.
I've carried a burden for too long on my own. I wasn't created to bear it alone. I hear your invitation to let it all go. I see it now, I'm laying it down. I know that I need you. I've run to the Father, full into grace. I'm done with the hiding, no reason to wait. My heart needs a surgeon, my soul needs a friend. So I run to the Father again and again and again and again. Saw my condition, had a plan from the start. Your son for redemption, the price for my heart. I don't have a context for that kind of love. Don't understand, I can't comprehend. All I know is I need you. I'm brought to the Father, full into grace.
eyes long before my first breath.
Many of you know that I love the sport of basketball. If you didn't catch this before, let's take a quick look at this part of my story. One sport that I've always loved has been basketball. I've always been pretty decent, and if there was one thing I could always do, it was shoot that ball. Even though I didn't grow up with him, my dad was a very good player from all the stories that I've heard, and he even got offered a basketball scholarship to college. But for some reason, he didn't make it to school. When I first got to high school, I loved two things in everything in the world. It was music and it was basketball. I used to watch NBA games as a little kid growing up in New Jersey, and my mom would take me to the New Jersey Nets basketball games. In fact, it was there that I got to see my favorite player, Michael Jordan, play from the first or second row. Thank you, Mom, for setting that up and doing that for me. Anyways, as a freshman in high school, I would play ball all around the neighborhood with friends. I even made the freshman basketball team. Our team was very, very good. For that season, we were 15-1. Now, I wasn't a starter, but we were good, and I was happy to be a part of that team. My sophomore year, we got a new coach from out of town, and I decided to try out for the JV team. I went to all the tryouts, all the practices, and we had teams of five. Don't you know everybody on my team of five made the team but me? Everybody except me. And I'm the one who told us the plays we should run, and I thought I had did everything that the coach wanted. But still, I got cut from the team. And at that moment, it felt like my life was over, and I didn't know what I was gonna do. Whenever I think about that time in my life, I think about how hard it was and how beat down I felt. You ever felt beat down? You ever feel like you wanted God to do something for you and He didn't do it? You ever feel like you knew just what you wanted God to do and it was all laid out in your mind and what you thought was going to happen just didn't happen? And in fact, the good you wanted and thought was going to happen actually turned out bad, and it felt like God maybe even wasn't there. That's how I felt in that moment of my life, and for a while. It was a dark time. When I didn't make the basketball team, people made fun of me, including my friends. And when your friends talk about you and make fun of you, that doesn't feel good at all. Young people, can you relate? I remember I was so down. I thought, how could this get any worse? Well, I needed something to do after school, and some of my friends had convinced me to join the track team. This was something I thought I would never, ever do, because all they did was run around in a circle. Who does that? Or rather, who wants to do that? I don't know. But so it began, and I ran, and I ran, and I ran. And guess what? I lost, and I lost, and I lost. That thought of couldn't get any worse had become a reality. I felt like a loser. and I had hit rock bottom. I thought to myself, why is this not working out? Where is God? Why hasn't he done what I thought he was going to do?
Red Bryant, it's Palm Sunday. Why are you telling us this story? You always got a lot of stories, man. Help us to understand what you're talking about.
Okay, Jordan, I will. First, let's talk about the scripture. Tell me again what it says.
Okay. The scripture says in John 12, The next day a great multitude had come to the feast. When they had heard that Jesus was coming to Jerusalem, they took branches of palm trees and went out to meet him and cried, Hosanna! Hosanna! Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, King of Israel. Then Jesus, when he had found a young donkey, sat on it, as it is written, Fear not, daughter of Zion. Behold, your king is coming, sitting on a donkey's colt.
Thanks, Jordan. So there were a lot of people following Jesus at this time because of his teaching and the awesome miracles he had done, including raising Lazarus from the dead. When we get to this Sunday, it's actually the beginning of the end of Jesus' earthly ministry. Jesus was intentional about this timing and the fulfillment of the prophecy of Zechariah 9:9. He knows that there will be Jews and people gathered from all around the known world to Jerusalem to celebrate the Feast of the Passover. Jesus uses this opportunity to show himself as the Messiah and rides in on a donkey's colt, which brings life to the words of Zechariah, Fear not, daughter of Zion. Behold, your king is coming, sitting on a donkey's colt. The people saw this and saw Jesus as a king, one who they thought was coming to liberate or free them from the political and hostile oppression or the bad times that they had been under. You see, the people had waved and laid down palm branches as a sign of worship and praise to Jesus, thinking he was going to be the king and now come and take over and make things better for all of the Jews.
Oh, so they thought Jesus would be a king and kick some butt.
Yes, they did. They shouted Hosanna, meaning save us. The crowd thought that Jesus was going to save them in one way, but they didn't understand that Jesus came to save them in another way.
Oh, that's really sad that the people didn't understand what Jesus was going to do. But Reverend Brian, why didn't Jesus just kick the bad people's butt and take over?
That's a great question, Jordan. Honestly, there's a couple reasons for that. One is that if you really look at the rest of the scripture in Zechariah, it talks about how the king is just and having salvation, and he shall speak peace to the nations. I think people miss that part. The salvation that Jesus was bringing for us to have eternal life with him, that's what it was. Jesus came not to conquer or condemn the known world, but he came in peace to save us from our sins and pay the price as the living sacrifice in our place.
Reverend Brian?
Yes?
Living sacrifice?
Yes.
Come on, man. It's kids watching.
Oh, yes, Jordan, but the kids need to understand this because the people of Israel could not atone for their own sin through the sacrifices of bulls or goats anymore. So God provided the lamb without blemish, once and for all, so that our sins could be washed away.
Washed away?
Yes, washed away. The main purpose of why Jesus was coming to die for us, taking on our sins at the cross, and then defeating death and restoring us in a right relationship with God Almighty forever.
Okay, so Jesus came to die for our sins. He came to take our place on the cross because the wages of our sin is death, literally and figuratively, in separation from God. And Palm Sunday marks the beginning of Holy Week, the time where we will see the passion of Jesus Christ, where he demonstrates his love for us, taking on our sin and laying down his life so that his blood will wash us clean and we can have direct fellowship with God through him. Right?
Right.
Reverend Brian?
Yes.
So what does your basketball story have to do with all of that?
Well, the connection is when it comes to the people or the crowd. The people who praised Jesus as he came in riding on the donkey are some of the same ones who were yelling, Crucify him, at the end of the week. Like Pastor Langston taught us last year, these people got caught up in the moment because they thought God was going to do something that he didn't do, and it made them very angry. I was angry with God when I didn't make the basketball team, and the time to follow was very hard for me. The people of Israel had been on hard times, and they were ready for God to deliver them and make things better, because that's what we all think God should do. God should make things better, right? He should make things easy for us, We believe him in so many things and should always go our way, and we should always get what we want. Right? No, not really. That's not how it works. Because sometimes we as Christians, we have to suffer. And that's all right. Listen, for me, I later realized that God's plan was better than my plan. Yes, I didn't make the team. Yes, I was made fun of. Yes, I lost a lot of races on the track team. Yes, I wanted to quit. And yes, I worked hard and didn't see where it was paying off for a long time. But like the scripture says in Psalm 119, it was good for me that I had been afflicted, that I might learn thy statutes. God was teaching me so much through pain and suffering. He was teaching me to trust in him and to not lean onto my own understanding. He was also teaching me humility and grace. God was also making me into a leader, one who could relate to the people and the trials of life. He was building up my strength to endure, making me stronger than I was before. He was pruning me, cutting my branches back so that I could grow more and bear fruit. Oh, taste and see how the Lord is good. The pain and the suffering that you are going through, it doesn't mean that God has forgotten you or that what you're doing is a waste of time. God is working his mighty hand and his mighty plan in your life. Pray to him. Stay in his word. Obey his spirit. Don't be like the crowd, cursing God when he doesn't do what you want him to do. Remember, he is not Santa Claus. God knew for me personally that if I kept playing basketball, I would not be where I am today. I probably wouldn't have gone to college. I might not understand what it means to work hard and pursue goals. I was so used to getting by on my natural talent, but God showed me that you got to have discipline and you got to lean on him. So what will you do during this Holy Week? What plans do you have that you need to set down and hear from God and what he wants in your life? This is a time where we can learn from Jesus. Jesus set aside his human feelings and emotions and followed God's will. And Palm Sunday represents the beginning of the end of that journey. It reminds me that the price of atonement was God's love and God's majesty. And it reminds me that praise always leads me to Jesus. God loves you, and so do I. Be blessed and be a blessing. Amen, amen, and amen.
Father, we thank you for your love, which is the foundation of our faith, our hope, and our belief. For your word says in Romans 5:8, but God demonstrates his own love for us in this, that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. Lord, we just ask right now that if there is anyone listening to this message who doesn't know you as their personal Lord and Savior, that you open their hearts right now, Lord, and draw them nearer to you. For those who may be listening, you want to start a personal relationship with Jesus, who is the Christ, won't you say this with me? Lord, I am a sinner. But your word says that all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. Father, I believe that Jesus is real and that he died for my sins. And on the third day, you rose him from the dead. I confess this with my mouth. I receive your precious gift of salvation, eternal life with you. I believe this in my heart, and therefore take on righteousness of Christ. Amen, amen, and amen.
On behalf of our pastor and all the youth and young adult leadership, we hope you've enjoyed this time with us and that the message provided speaks to your heart in a positive way. Remember that you are powerful beyond measure and that there's greatness inside of you. Each one of us has a personal responsibility to light up the world, spread love through our words and our actions. Remember, this day, Palm Sunday, is a day for us all to reflect on what God sent Jesus to do for us and how his agape love for you and I is unconditional. When Jesus went to the cross for us, he was fulfilling God's ultimate plan to bring salvation to this dying world. Taking on the sins of the universe, enduring excruciating pain and torture, even until death. Let us pay homage and respect during this Holy Week, and may we never, ever forget the love and the sacrifice that surrounds each and every one of our lives. There are blessings all around us. Let us run to the Father with a pep in our step and joy in our hearts, for He's worthy of it. Wouldn't you agree? Amen. 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 And now unto Him who is able to keep you from falling
and present you faultless
before the presence of His glory
with exceeding joy,
to the only wise God our Savior
be glory,
majesty,
dominion, and power,
both now and forevermore. Amen, amen, and amen.